Are you ready for your next comedian? Oh, I am so excited. Oh my gosh. We have a Portland icon coming to the stage. Another fellow Jew, like myself, so a lot of relate to. They look amazing right now. They really stayed to theme. And I'm so excited to have her on the stage. Danelle Porter, get up here!
Oh, okay. Portland icon. That's not what I told her to say when she brought me up. I believe what I said to say, Aaliyah, was she's the reason why we have this show. It's because I used to run the Saturday show every week for like a year and a half. And then I gave it up because I went to London and I was changed after that. That's not funny at all. It's just a fact. I don't know. I'm a people pleaser, so to hear that I'm a Portland icon just gives me so much anxiety right now. I feel like a scared dog right now. Like, we're working on it in therapy, but apparently not working on it enough. I'm in therapy. I love therapy. Anybody in therapy in here? Good for you. Good for you. I'm working on yourself. I'm in therapy because when I was 18 years old, I told my mom that I thought I was depressed, and she said, "No, honey, you just need to change your diet." And now I just do whatever the opposite she ever says to do, which is why I believe in modern medicine and Febreze. So therapy's good. I really like my therapist. I actually want to be friends with my therapist. Does anybody want to be friends with their therapist? No, just me. I'm the weird one. It's fine. I want to be friends with my therapist so fucking badly. She's so cool. She does really, like, amazing things. Like, she's nice to me. And she got pregnant at the same time as my cousins. We're working on my abandonment issues together. It's nice. It's really nice. She likes to test me in ways where I think like we're having breakthroughs, but then she tells me, no, we're not. Actually, our internet connection is breaking up because we're doing Zoom therapy. It is trying, honestly. Sometimes I think we're having breakthroughs. Like I was in session with her one day and I was like having a moment and I was just like, look, I just need somebody to come find me and take me home. And my therapist, she got like all stoic and went, whoa, that gave me chills. And I was just like, yes, it's happening. We're bonding. I'm not gonna have to pay for therapy anymore. She's just gonna do it for free. And then I sat there for a second and took a breath and I was just like, you dumb bitch. I remembered that I had just been listening to Avril Lavigne's I'm With You before therapy, and I was just quoting Avril Lavigne. And I really struggled with if I should tell her or not, because it's like, you can't tell your therapist that you're just quoting Avril Lavigne. You can't quote early 2000s pop music. It's not an episode of The Office. So I did tell her, though, because I'm a comedian, and I'd been bombing at a lot of mics, and getting a laugh from your therapist is like... So I told her, but I told her in, like, a fun way. I was like, you know, as the great Canadian singer Avril Lavigne once said, I'm standing on a bridge, I'm waiting in the dark. I thought someone would be here by now. And then she got all quiet again. And then she was like, I think you should come in twice next week. Yeah, therapy is fun. It's good. I don't know. You guys got all sad for me. Don't get sad. Just laugh or just... I don't know, jot it down in your notes to be like, that's sad for that girl. Because otherwise, this is a waste of my goddamn time. I don't know. Drew was saying, like, he didn't know why he was here. I don't know why I'm here, because I am, like, the least kinky person in this room. And I like being choked, but I got the message, like, wear something, like, animal print, like, if you have a fursuit. And I was just like, I don't. I had some orange footy pajamas that had foxes on the feet when I was 15, but I don't. That's, like, the closest I've gotten. I don't know. I just. I am queer. Sometimes I feel like I'm not queer because straight people tell me that they think I'm straight. And it's weird because, like, I try to date women, but they don't like me. Like, I can't get them to like. I think they just can see where the cum used to be. I am trying to date more. I'm on, like, the dating apps, and I'm really bad at the dating apps because I can't read. I'm not, like, illiterate like Jesus or anything. I'm just dyslexic. The dating apps are so hard for me. Like, you can't come back from asking a guy, like, how do you like being a pedestrian for a living? That man was a pediatrician. I, like, fuck up names and careers, too. Like, I don't like asking people what their names are because I'm going to fuck up their name. And so instead I give them, like, cute nicknames. And the last guy I dated, because he was, I called him Autistic Guy. I don't know. I just, like, the reason why I don't give, like, I don't say people's names is, like, it started back in high school. I was in the 10th grade, and I got a you guys remember poking from Facebook? Yeah, I got a if you don't remember what poking is, it's basically where you get a notification saying so and so poked you, and that's it. You don't get any money. So I got poked by this guy, and I was like, he poked everyone, so I had to find out if he was poking my friends too. And so I was like, hey, did you guys get poked by Jacob Sedildo? That wasn't his name. but it was for the rest of high school. That's sort of how I became an internet bully for the first time. Yeah, now I bully suburban moms. It's quite a rush. His real name is Jacob Cedillo, and it turns out I'm dyslexic in every language. He was Mexican. I don't know. I don't know if you've noticed. I haven't made any eye contact with any of you. I don't like making eye contact. I treat making eye contact the same way I treat trying anal. Only on my boyfriend's birthday. Yeah, you guys caught on. I'm so fucking single. Like, I'm I'm so single to the point that, like, the most intimacy I've had in months is, like, a teeth cleaning with my dental hygienist. Okay, but it was really hot. It was really hot. She kept doing things like turn this way and almost there and oops, sorry, I squirted on you. And then after we finished, she, like, looked me in my eyes, which I don't really like, and she went, do you want one or two toothbrushes? You guys know they don't do that for everyone, right? I go back, like, every 3 days now because, you know, mama needs to get drilled. Ugh. I don't know. I'm trying to be more positive, but that's just me starting every week off by taking my Adderall, chasing it with some mushrooms and a yerba mate tea. I call it a Portland speedball. It's my own special recipe. I don't know. You gotta clean your kitchen and see God. It's a good time. Oh, I don't know. I've been taking Adderall for a while now, and I like it a lot. It's been good for me. It's helped my ADHD a lot. But I did like notice this weird thing happening. Has anybody ever taken so much Adderall that they realize that they're autistic? It's weird. It's weird because like I'll go to parties with my friends and they'll take it and have a good time, and I'll take it and find out that I now love trains. I don't know. I like it a lot. It's fine. I'm fading. My yerba mate wore off. I have high functioning depression. Can you tell? It's because I'm a woman and I can multitask. All it really means is I can work really, really hard all day long and then go and cry in my car. I should mention I work from home. I'm actually unemployed. I used to work for my mom, which I don't recommend. Don't work for my mom. We mix business with childhood trauma. We're kind of like Disney. Yeah, my mom sort of has the energy of Cruella DeVille, but like Jewish. She's not turning those puppies into coats. Unfortunately, she is turning them into yarmulkes. Anybody want the Etsy link? Find me after the show. Actually, one time she sat right over there and watched me make fun of her. It was a great time. My therapist called it bonding. I don't know. Being unemployed is really great, though. I like it a lot. I just watch a lot of Rugrats Go to Paris and eat mushrooms. I don't know if they've made it. There's like a lizard, and they could be in Japan for all I know. I did do this one thing that that I never thought I would do since I've been unemployed, because I'm so fucking bored. I'm so bored all the time. I cleaned my house for the first time. And here's something you can take home with you. If you clean under your bed, you can find the vibrator charging cord that you've been missing for over a year. Yeah. The thing is, though, I'm not going to charge that vibrator. It's been too long. It's just a regular toothbrush now. All right, guys. Thank you so much.